Love of God and the grace of Jesus Christ and the community of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
We join together in our call to worship. God celebrates with us.
In times of deep joy.
God grieves with us.
In his seasons of sadness.
And God walks with us. Our opening hymn this morning, appropriate for a Music Scholar Sunday, is Praise the Lord with the Sound of Trumpet. Welcome to all of you to worship at Knox, whether you're a regular or whether it's your first time or just checking us out, you are welcome here. No strings attached, you are welcome here. We welcome as well those listening in on CKWR 98.5 Community Radio and those live streaming on YouTube. Sometimes you'll see me on my phone up here. I'm actually not texting friends, and I'm not checking out the score of the ball game. No, right now there are 36 devices streaming. About a third of our live worshiping community is online, and sometimes I'll check to see if there's some chat. And so when you see me on my phone up here, and somebody asked me and say, "What are you doing with your phone?" It's like I'm communicating with the rest of the unseen Knox community. That's what I'm doing. Just thought I'd clear the air with that one. This is Music Scholar Sunday. A lot of moving parts today. There's always lots of things to celebrate at Knox, and today we take some time to thank our music scholars, to welcome our new music scholars, and to have them share their gifts today. And so we welcome Cassidy and Vlad and Natalia and Alicia, and we thank you in advance. We're looking forward to the variety of music, and I'm looking for MC, and I see that she's right behind me. So, and thank you, MC, of course, for all the work you and the choir do on a regular basis. We're really grateful. Our prayer has begun in our singing and in our connecting with one another and in our laughter too. I'd like to pray using some words. Loving God, Creator, Mother, Father, Parent of all, Source of life and love, Source of potential, you are greater than our best thought. You are deeper than our most profound experience. You are closer than our next breath. You are. We cannot tell you anything that would surprise you. You know us, every part of us, and we need not feel shame, for you are love. You are embrace. you are acceptance. In the mystery that is you, sometimes we feel summoned, and sometimes we stumble into that holy ground where earth vibrates with heaven, and the hardest heart softens, and the most resilient will bends, and the soul overwhelmed with pain cries glory. We are grateful to you, O God, that you meet us here and now. As we encounter you in word, music, silence, and community, may our hearts be touched by your Spirit. In the Spirit of Christ, we offer these prayers, the Christ who taught the disciples to pray the words which we now sing together. Got good news for you all today. This is good news that it's a privilege for me to share. It's good news that I need to remind myself of, as I remind you all of, and that is that in Christ we are being made into new creations. The old life in us is being transformed. That transformation has already begun in us, whether or not we're aware of it. That transformation is happening right now, and that transformation will continue in us because God is good. And God wishes to turn us into something new and something even more beautiful than we already are. This is a gift, and God's grace is a part of it, and we give God thanks and praise. Peace of Christ be with you. Wherever you happen to be, I'd invite you to stand or sit and extend words or gesture of peace to one another. Peace be with you. Join me up here at the front. You're welcome to come on down. We're going to sing a hallelujah song today. Oh, you don't have to. You don't have to come down, truly. You can stay where you are. But you're welcome to if you want. Yeah, anyone can come down. Hey, awesome. Yeah. Awesome. Great. Yeah, thank you. Great to see you today. Did you notice in the opening hymn that we sang today, that fun one, praise the Lord with the sound of trumpet, praise the... The word praise was used a lot. Have you ever thought about what that word means, the word praise? What does the word praise mean? When we say praise God, what do you think? Yeah, it's okay. That's okay. You might remember later on what you were going to say. I have trouble defining the word praise. And so I looked it up in the library. We use that word all the time, don't we? We're going to praise God. We gather to praise God. Like, but what does it really mean? It's like, sometimes in worshiping communities or faith communities, we have a secret language. And we don't really understand the language sometimes, but we use it anyway. So I looked up in the dictionary, the word praise. And this is what I found in the Oxford Dictionary. To express warm approval of or admiration of, to admire, to express approval of. Approval is kind of like, yeah, you're okay. So we're saying, yeah, God, you know what? You're not too bad. You're okay. You're okay by me. That's approval. I approve of you. Thumbs up. Another dictionary said to extol, and I thought, okay, I don't understand that word either. Like, it's funny when you look in the library in the dictionary sometimes, and you want to find the definition of one word, and they give you another word which you don't understand either. So you have to look up another word. What does praise mean? Praise can mean a whole bunch of different things. I went walking in the woods the other day, and I heard the cardinals, and I heard the blue jays in the trees, and I thought, I wonder if the birds are praising God. And then I heard a dog barking in the distance, and I thought, I wonder if that dog is praising God. Just by being a dog and by doing dog things, maybe that's what praise is. Just enjoying the life that that dog has been given. Those birds enjoying the life that they've been given. Did you remember what you're going to say?
When I was in the forest one,
yeah?
I heard a banana dance.
Did you? Well, you know, maybe a banana praises God just by being a banana. Just by hanging on the tree, waiting for someone to enjoy it, or waiting for it to fall to create a new banana tree. That's bananas praise God just by being bananas. And maybe we praise God just by being fully human, by being the best kind of human beings that we can be. And we express that praise in so many different ways. All through the week, we express praise to God by remembering God when we're at work or when we're at play or when we're eating, when we're with friends. And sometimes we gather together like we do today and we remember that we need to praise, that we need to remember. We gather so that we can remember that we need to remember God. And so we do that in all kinds of different ways. We pray and we enjoy each other's company, and gosh, we have lots and lots of music, because music, remember the birds in the trees? That's kind of what we do. We sing like the birds in the trees, and when we sing, we praise, and there's going to be so much music here today. I thought it would be kind of fun for us to sing a hallelujah song, because the word hallelujah means praise, and this is a song from the Caribbean, and we've sung it before. Yeah, this is, it goes like this. Halle, 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 luia. Halle, 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 luia. Halle, 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 luia. Halleluia, halleluia. Somebody clapped. Somebody remembered. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeah, let's do it again. Here we go. Halle, halle, hallelujah. Halle, halle, hallelujah. Halle, halle, halle. Hallelujah, hallelujah. See, I'm wanting to go faster. You can tell, can't you? Halle, halle, halle. Fun singing and dancing with you. And where is Femi? Femi is going to lead you to your own worship centers today. Thank you, Femi, for that. Femi can grab the shepherd's crook. We'll see you afterwards. Thanks for dancing. Thanks for singing. Thanks for having fun.
Seasons of love.
The scripture reading today is from the book of Psalms. There are 150 psalms in the Psalter, in the book of Psalms. And it's like the hymnal of the Hebrew Scriptures, the hymnal of the Old Testament. We have our blue hymnals, our books of praise. This is like the Old Testament book of praise. Contains all kinds of music. Unfortunately, we don't have the musical notation for these hymns, for the psalms, but we do have the lyrics. Anytime we read a psalm, we're actually reading a song, a poem. And this is a song, the lyrics of a song, for which we have no music. This is the psalm which concludes the Psalter. It's the last psalm in the entire book. And I thought it'd be kind of fun for us to read it responsively today. Praise God. Praise God in the sanctuary. Praise God in the mighty firmament. Praise God for mighty deeds. Praise God according to surpassing greatness. Praise God with trumpet sound. Praise with lute and harp. Praise God with tambourine and dance. Praise with strings and pipe. Praise God with clanging cymbals. Praise with loud clashing cymbals. Let everything that breathes praise God. Praise God. Amen.
Sometimes it's hard to know what's the right way to go. Sometimes it's as clear as glass, and other times as murky as mud. But there's a path that's waiting for you. There is freedom.
Psalm 150, the psalm which we read a moment ago, is one of my favorite psalms in all of the Psalter. It's really wonderful to hear it read out loud. With all the musical references, though, it truly would be better if we had the music, don't you think, and could sing it together. Many years ago, I sang in a choir which sang an arrangement, a modern arrangement of this song, and of this psalm, rather. And like the psalm itself, the arrangement was loud, and it was upbeat, and it was joyful. We sang it with a spirit of unrestrained enthusiasm. It was truly a joy to sing that piece. And every time we sang it, I could not get George Frideric Handel out of my head. On April the 13th, 1742, in Dublin, Ireland, Handel's new oratorio, The Messiah, was performed and heard by the world for the very first time. And perhaps the most popular piece in that entire work, and the most sung piece, the most recognizable piece, is the Hallelujah Chorus. Hallelujah! You know that one, right? Yeah. Hallelujah! Well, in Hebrew, as I've shared with you in other weeks, the word hallelujah is a really interesting word. It's a combination of two Hebrew words, the word hallelu, which means praise, and the word yah, which is an abbreviated form of an ancient name for God, Yahweh. So when you put hallelu and Yahweh together, you get hallelujah, which means, translated, praise God. I like to call Psalm 150 the Hallelujah Chorus of the Psalter. Because in Psalm 150, we are called to praise God, to hallelujah, no less than 13 times. Thank you. I've always found it interesting that this Hallelujah Psalm, Psalm 150, was chosen by the unnamed editors of the Psalter to conclude the Psalter, to be the last hymn in the hymnal. The whole Psalter ends on this note of exuberant joy and praise. But when we read through the Psalter as a whole, however, we become aware of the fact that not all of the Psalms are joyful. In fact, quite the opposite. In the Psalms, we see the wonderful spectrum, the range of human emotion and thought. Yes, some of the Psalms are joyful in nature, but other Psalms are filled with pain and sorrow. Other Psalms express a profound melancholy. Other Psalms reveal an intense anger at God. Every human emotion is contained in the Psalter, in the Psalms. Every human emotion. And yet, here at the very end of the Psalter, Psalm 150, we have the whole book concluding with this outpouring of praise. Don't you find that interesting? I find that really interesting. I wonder if the Psalter was organized this way for a reason. After all, the variety of emotion that we find in the Psalms reflects the ups and downs of normal, everyday human life. We have our good days, our bad days. We have our days of joy, our days of sadness. We have our days of despair and rage. And yet, isn't it also true that we can still acknowledge God, that we can still praise God, we can still come before God, no matter how we may be feeling at any particular time? And is this honesty not a part of authentic praise? Praising God is not dependent upon feeling joyful. And by praise, I mean what we talked about with the kids, acknowledging God, remembering God. We can be sad and still acknowledge God and still praise God in our sadness. We can be nostalgic and still praise God in our nostalgia. We can feel anger and rage and still praise God in our rage. The variety of emotion in our day-to-day lives is mirrored in the variety of emotion we find in the Psalms. And I wonder, could closing the whole book with a psalm of praise be meant as some sort of summary of this range of human emotion? Could it be that everything that comes before Psalm 150, the ups and downs of emotion and feeling, is a part of what it is to praise God? I wonder sometimes if when we get in touch with our authentic human emotion, that's part of what it is to praise God. When we deepen our awareness into our authentic humanity, that is what praise is. I wonder that. Could it be that praise, this wholehearted worship of God we find in Psalm 150, is a canopy vast enough to include the whole spectrum of human emotion which the entire Psalter presents? Could it be? I wonder. Let's sing together. When in our music, God is glorified. If you'd like to follow along the musical notation for this, it's number 439 in the blue hymnal. Peace be with you. What a joyful day this has been and continues to be. So, so grateful for the rich talent of so many in our midst, especially today to our music scholars. We're going to get to them in just a minute. Thank you for being a part of the community today. You're a part of the community, whether you just drop in every once in a while or whether you're here every Sunday. You're part of the community. If you listen in on radio, streaming, live streaming, or one of the many who check us out on YouTube after the fact, you're part of the community, and this community is richer because you are a part of it. I'm going to ask MC to introduce our scholars and say a few words about the Music Scholar Program. Thank you, MC.
Good morning, everyone. We're thrilled to welcome all our scholars here this morning. I'm going to start with the faces that might be a bit more familiar to you, and then we'll introduce our newer faces. So first of all, our soprano scholar, stand up when I say your name, people. Okay, Cassidy Hengartner. Cassidy is in third year at Laurier, and what's your major? Western classical music is the major. Excellent. And how long have you been a scholar? For 3 years, I suppose, right? Excellent. Love it. Okay. Alicia Vorstenbosch, our alto scholar, and you heard Alicia on the harp this morning as well. Alicia is in fifth year at Laurier and just wrapped up a really exciting term studying in Ireland, which is why we didn't have her in the springtime. I have no idea why she would prefer to be in Ireland than prefer to be here, but hard decisions, I suppose. All right, and we have two new scholars this term. First, we have Natalia Sawyer, our brand new piano scholar. And Natalia is also a third year student at Laurier. And last but not least, we have a new baritone scholar, Vlad Motchek. And Vlad is a fifth-year student at Conrad Grable, my alma mater, so it's great to have you with us. And you're a vocal major, correct? Awesome. All right, give it up for all of our scholars. In terms of what the scholars do here, it might be pretty obvious that they sing with the choir, obviously, but they do more than sing with the choir. They crack jokes, and I'm just kidding, they do that very well. And they help provide section leadership to our singers. They help us learn our music quicker. They've been known to fill in for me when someone got very sick and couldn't be at choir for 2 weeks. They ran the rehearsal in my stead. So they're very capable, wonderful human beings, and we're very lucky to have this music scholar program here at Knox since the 1980s under Brian Johnston's music direction. And it continues to this day. Thank you to your support for keeping it going. This is a program that we're very proud to have and hope to have for many years in the future. So thank you, scholars, for doing what you do.
And do you want to say something about Christmas cantata, MC?
Sure. We just started our Christmas choir rehearsals this past Thursday. We had a great turnout for that, but more people are always welcome. So, and you need not have choral experience. We provide you with music, and we teach everything nice and at a good pace that you can learn everything. So if that's of interest to you, we start rehearsing the Christmas music around 8 p.m. every Thursday. So you can come join us in the sanctuary, and we look forward to seeing you there.
Thank you, MC. Thank you so much. A couple of brief other community announcements. One is that the men's breakfast is going to be happening next Saturday. If you identify as male and want to come, you're welcome to. And next slide. Oh, yes, Anniversary Sunday. Next Sunday, we are really thrilled to have the Reverend Amanda Curry, who is the minister in Regina, First Church Regina. And she is going to be attending worship with us next week and helping to lead us in worship to celebrate our 135th anniversary, and we're really excited about that. The session retreat is actually happening on Saturday as well, so I invite you the Saturday of next week. So session retreat on Saturday, anniversary Sunday on Sunday. I'd like to invite you to mark on your calendars to say an extra prayer for the leadership of our church, the session on Saturday. Send us some good energy, some good discernment, some prayers, and we would appreciate that support from the whole community. A session meets to pray about and talk about and think about the ministries of Knox Waterloo. Yeah, this is probably my favorite image in the whole world when it comes to God. So I want to tell you just a short story about last Thursday. I sat at a table on Thursday for an interfaith Grand River meeting. Once a month, the interfaith community of Kitchener-Waterloo meets. And I've decided to join that group because I think interfaith relationship is just really, really important. Don't you think it's really important right now? Yeah. So we had a fascinating conversation. I sat at a table with 25 other faith community leaders, and we represented Protestant and Roman Catholic Christian traditions, the Buddhist faith, the Baha'i faith, the Jewish faith, and various Muslim traditions. We sat at a table, and we shared stories of how the news these days, what's going on in Israel and Palestine, is affecting us. And then we ran around the circle again and shared ideas of what we as faith communities can do. That's a hard question, other than pray and talk about it sometimes. I want to say that it was just such a deep privilege to be at a table with people, a place where Jews and Muslims and other faith traditions could express grief at the loss of civilian life and at the loss of life, period, because of this conflict. The harder question of what we can do as a community, we're still struggling with that. At some point in time, we hope to actually do some kind of liturgy or some kind of ceremony or some kind of ritual to send to the community, that there are those in our communities from the traditions which are fighting in the Middle East which actually want peace here. I think that's a really important message to send, especially when we're finding and hearing on the news about manifestations of anger and rage in unhealthy ways in our own communities. So I just wanted you to know that in Kitchener-Waterloo, there are those of us from a whole bunch of faith traditions which are holding this deeply and working to try to think about how we can address it in Kitchener and Waterloo. So that's for your information. And of course, we continue to pray for the situation in the Middle East, as well as the wars in the world, which are not making the headlines these days, like the continued war in Ukraine and the wars that have been happening in the still struggle in Syria. Just Google wars in the world and you'll see the long list of conflicts that you don't hear about. It's time for the offering. Ministries like the Music Scholar Ministry exist because of your generosity. We have no hidden funds that we draw from to support this. The Presbytery of Waterloo Wellington helps us with that ministry, but it's because of your gifts that we can invite students to be a part of our community and share their gifts with us and provide them with a safe place to learn and perform and grow. It's an amazing gift. They receive gifts as well as give gifts, don't you think? There's an amazing reciprocity to this program. So we're gonna pass the plates, and I know a lot of you give electronically. If you feel a little self-conscious about having a plate and have nothing to put in it or give another way, there are little green cards nearby you. You can put a green card in a plate just as a gesture if you'd like to embody that act of giving. Let's take a few moments. And while we do that, Vlad is going to share a gift with us as well. Thank you for that.
Must walk this lonesome valley. We have to walk it by ourselves. Oh, nobody else can walk it for us. We have to walk it by ourselves. We have to walk. We to walk. We have to walk it by ourselves. But I want you, Lord, to walk with me.
Continue our prayer together. Loving God, sometimes you don't seem very close or real to us, only a word, a thought, a longing maybe, a hope. And you may wonder whether we care much about you at all. Sometimes we wonder just how much we care about you. But there are things we do care about, ourselves mostly, and some people we feel close to, families, friends, children. We do care what happens to them. So we do care about love, O God, about being loved and about loving. And we wonder about it, how to do it, what makes us want to do it. With those close to us, O God, we care about laughing and crying and learning, talking honestly, a little, and fighting openly and fairly, and forgiving a bit more, and admitting we want to be forgiven and need to be forgiven. We care about things, God, about getting them and being gotten by them. And we do care about money and all the things we do for it and with it and what it does to us. And we care about being a little freer of all that somehow. We care about our neighbors, God, at least some of them sometimes, and about all the things that would make it better and perhaps easier for us to live together, and the hard decisions and sacrifices it would take for that to happen. Which means, God, that we do care about justice, though too often from a distance, because we care about what it might require of us, and then we get testy or silent, but we are haunted by it because something in us won't let us stop caring about it, even though we wish we could. And so we care about our enemies, God, and are tired of being angry and suspicious so much, which is such a waste. And we care about the least, those who are hungry and sick and terrorized and exploited, because we care about peace and we long for that inside and out, and we are weary of being afraid for ourselves and the children. We care about this tiny, fragile blue planet, God, this home, this Mother Earth, and all the creatures who share the mystery of life. And we really do care about beauty, God, about the songs in us, the poems, the stories, We care deeply about the wondrous, puzzling, and aching struggle that we are. We care about this joy that we feel, flickering sometimes, flaring sometimes, when we touch hands or eyes or minds or souls, and then we ache for more. We care about living more faithfully, O God, living more abundantly. We care about what makes us restless, makes us reach and stretch and grope for words, for dreams, for other people, for you. Oh God, you. We do care about you, sometimes fiercely, or we wouldn't be stumbling along like this, trying to pray, trying to put ourselves in your way. We care about you, and such is our faith, however faltering it is, and we trust that past words, you care about all these things that we care about. You care about them more, infinitely more than we can care about them, which means that you care for us even when we are careless. And in this we rest. In this we are grateful. These prayers, both spoken and unspoken, these prayers which lie so deep they cannot even be put into words, we offer them in the spirit of the risen Christ. And together God's people say, Amen. Our closing hymn, Lord Jesus, You Shall Be My Song, number 665. As we prepare to go our separate ways this morning, I invite you, as you carry on, to sing the song which is your life, to remember that the God who made you, the Christ who mends you, and the Spirit who molds you walks with you every step of the way in this song. Amen. I'm Hugh Donnelly, one of the ministers at Knox Waterloo. Thank you for being a part of the worshiping community today. You can find us online at knoxwaterloo.ca, and you are always welcome to call us at 519-886-4150. This broadcast is made possible by you, listeners and friends of Knox, who support Knox's broadcast ministry. Please consider making a donation in gratitude as you are able, and may the peace of Christ be with you.